These are the Wangaris, a nomadic food-gathering people always on the move. Even today they still follow their old ways of life, taking about with them their few weapons, tools and dilly bags, which are their only worldly possessions. Today, in the 20th century, they are people who are still living in the ways of the Stone Age. The aprons these people wear, known as didi-didis, are their only form of clothing, made from the bark of the paper bark tree. Theirs is a simple way of life. At night, they settle down to camp wherever their wanderings have brought them. They may stay here for a few days, laughing and gossiping, hunting and food gathering until the area is exhausted, and then we'll move on. Their word for camp is nina, and means sit down. They camp down in family groups. Wives and daughters clear the ground of stones, twigs and prickly grass seeds. The men make fire by the primitive method of friction. The jarbuma is twirling a stick in a hole in another piece of wood in which he has placed some charcoal. When the charcoal is red hot, he shakes it into dry bark that has been finely shredded. He blows on the charcoal embers until they catch the bark. The earth is their bed, and they sleep in the open without covering in the long dry season. They make fires to keep them warm at night. In the season of monsoonal rains, however, they make themselves primitive shelters called bunbus, a very simple structure to shelter themselves from the heavy rain. The main support of the bunbu is a ring of bark cut from the gum tree. The men are using stone-headed axes. The bark is bent over and the ends are dug into the ground. If it stops raining and the sun comes out while they are making a bunbu, they will promptly stop work and only continue when it starts raining again. The structure is then covered with paper bark to stop the rain from coming through the cracks in the gum bark. When the man of the family has finished his part of the work, he crawls inside out of the rain and leaves his wife to finish off her part of the job. At night, the natives light fires at both ends of their bunbus. The smoke blows straight through and keeps away the mosquitoes. Sometimes the smoke is so thick that they sleep with their noses to cracks in the bark to get air. These platforms on stilts are sleeping racks. The native name is lundang. The natives light a fire beneath them and sleep in the smoke, which keeps away mosquitoes. After a meal, they go to their sleeping platform. coals to their little fires. In humid weather, the smoke keeps away mosquitoes. In cold weather, they curl up right round their fire and light another at their backs to keep their kidneys warm. They sometimes roll onto the fire in their sleep, and many Aborigines have scars of fire burns on their back and abdomens. The old and the young dream of good hunting grounds. Early in the morning, in the Piccaninny dawn, as they say, the tribe awake and prepare to leave for the day's hunting and food gathering. The Jarbuma leaves camp with his spear and woomera and a word of advice to his elder wife. Presently, the women go out collecting grubs, roots and wild honey and small animals. The men fish with spears inside the reef. The men do the more active forms of food gathering, such as hunting and fishing, while the women and children search for such food as can be found lying about. On the beach, Nominee, Mararawi and Widgiewidgie have seen a turtle track, and by this they know where she has laid her eggs. Turtles' eggs have soft, leathery shells and are very good to eat. The women dig up yam roots, the Aborigines' potato. Others in the swamps are collecting lily roots. They are soft and pulpy and are a native delicacy. The quest for food may go on all day. At low tide, the women and children search inside the reef for shellfish and crabs. The Aborigines eat almost anything they can catch. Here, a family group are coming into camp with a 10-foot rock python. Fires are made, and the python is heated to take out the stiffness so that it can be rolled up conveniently for cooking. The cooking is done by covering it with hot ashes from the fire. Another group have brought in a goanna, a sort of lizard which tastes rather like lobster. This old woman is making dough from ground waraka nuts. The dough is then wrapped in paper bark and placed in hot ashes. It is baked into a sort of bread. Carving the joint is done in a primitive but effective way. Table manners may seem crude, but it is not very long ago that the people of Britain were eating with their hands. shellfish are also popular. This is a large mud oyster that the woman is breaking open. Tidbits for the children. The baby, Billy Billy, is making a hearty if messy meal off wild honey. This is found inside hollow dead trees, and the children search for it by listening against the tree trunks for the buzzing of the bees. The local bee is small and stingless and is about the size of a housefly.